Hello everyone, this is Dr. Fox. Let's talk about the osteology of the larynx and pharynx. And let's begin with the hyoid bone. The hyoid bone gets its name from hyoideus, the Greek, which means shaped like an upsilon, which is somewhat U-shaped, and the hyoid bone is somewhat U-shaped. The hyoid bone is unique in the axial skeleton in that it doesn't physically articulate with any other bone. It sits suspended below the skull by the stylohyoid ligament from the styloid process of the temporal bone. It's superior to the laryngoskeleton, so it suspends the larynx by the thyrohyoid membrane, and it sits anterior to the cervical spine. Now, there are two sets of horns or cornua to which various features attach. There are the lesser horns, or cornua, to which those stylohyoid ligaments attach. And there are the greater horns, which are muscle attachment sites for several muscles. But in the context of this laboratory, they're going to be attachment sites for the middle pharyngeal constrictor muscles, as well as an articulation point for the superior horns of the thyroid cartilage. So next we have the skull, which has two elements, the larger of which in the akinetic or immobile part is called the cranium. The cranium surrounds the brain and provides the lion's share of the underlying architecture for the head and the face. One of the important bones of the cranium, which we can see a little of here in profile and a little more here looking at the basic cranium. Drawing pictures here, is the sphenoid bone. The sphenoid bone is one of my favorite bones. It's remarkably complex. It's rich with various foramina through which neurovasculature is transmitted. It has its own paranasal sinus. It can be seen from nearly any angle of the skull with the exception of the superior or the posterior. And it's just a very complex bone with that does a lot of important things. In the context of this lab, the medial plate of the sphenoid bone and the pterygoid hamulus, which are these structures, so that's the plate, at the end of the plate is the hamulus, is the superior structure to which the pterygomandibular raphae, which is the bulk of the attachment site for the superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle, attaches. So we can see a little bit of that here. So there's part of that plate. And that pterygomandibular raphae is going to run between that medial plate of the sphenoid and the mylohyoid line of the mandible, which we'll see shortly. In addition, let's erase this. There's also a temporal bone, and the temporal bone is rather extensive with respect to what we can see here, which has a feature that is germane to today's session, and that is the styloid process. We can see that there. You can see it's a little out of focus, but we can see one there and one there. Styloid from stylus, means sharp or pointy, like the stylus that you use on a touch screen. That styloid process is going to be a muscle and a ligament attachment site, but in the context of this session, it's an attachment site for the stylopharyngeus muscle of the pharynx. There's also an occipital bone. The occipital bone is posterior to the temporal bone, and also posterior to the sphenoid bone. Oops, no, that's temporal, sorry. The occipital bone forms the bulk of the floor of the basic cranium, as well as the posterior portion of the skull here. And its probably greatest feature here is the foramen magnum. That's the space through which the brainstem is contiguous with the spinal cord, and also we have the vertebral arteries and the cranial nerve 11, the accessory nerve traveling through. If we go anterior to this, however, there is a pharyngeal tubercle. That pharyngeal tubercle is the superior site where the investing fascia of the muscular wall of the pharynx attaches. So that is going to be where the pharyngeal raphae is going to attach. And that's a condensation of pharyngobasilar fascia in that region. Completing the skull is the mandible. Here is our anterior view of the mandible. And here is a medial view of a hemisected mandible. So we've cut through that mental region. And I want to share with you the mylohyoid line. The mylohyoid line is the attachment site for the mylohyoideus, or the mylohyoid muscle, which is the floor of the oral cavity. But probably more importantly, that posterior part of the mylohyoid line is where the pterygomandibular raphae, which is the attachment site for the superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle, attaches. So we've seen some of the osteological elements for this session and germane features to this session. Keep in mind there are very many other osteological elements and even features within the bones that I've discussed here today that are going to be important and a part of our study of human anatomy. Thank you very much for your time.